They don't want to make him, let him make it to the Christmas Night Army event. Eaton and Austin trying to destroy the Dragon. And here comes Barry Windham. Windham, and they meet Windham coming in. Windham's right hand in the cast. They're taking over on Windham. Steamboat has been decimated. The referees have been laid out. Oh, it's chaotic here. Hello again, everyone, and welcome to TBS and World Championship Wrestling. I'm Jim Ross, and we're coming to you from the center stage in Atlanta. We've got a great 90-minute broadcast, ladies and gentlemen. We'll talk more about what you just saw in our opening involving Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Barry Windham and the Dangerous Alliance, and I'll be talking to the Dangerous Alliance in this broadcast. Plus, fans, we're going to show you a recent altercation involving the Dangerous Alliance, specifically Ravishing Rick Rude and Sting. What you're going to see will shock you all. We'll have that in this broadcast. Plus, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to update you on the status involving Terrence Taylor and the York Foundation. We'll see Taylor in action. Also, a matchup involving super heavyweights. We'll see PN News at 4:03 and Mr. Hughes at 3:75. Plus, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be talking a great deal about tomorrow night's big event, exclusively on pay-per-view, live from the Norfolk Scope Arena. It's Starrcade 91. It's going to be a great broadcast. We're happy you're with us. And right now, let's go to the ring. And Rhubarb Jones, the World Tag Team Champions, are next.
Ladies and gentlemen, making their way into the ring area with a combined weight of 498 pounds, the World Tag Team Champions. They are coming to the ring by Barry Windham. Here comes from Charlotte, North Carolina, Ricky Steamboat, and from Austin, Texas, Dustin Rhodes. And introducing their opponents with a combined weight of 479 pounds, Chris Sullivan and John Peterson.
World Tag Team Champions to kick it off here on TBS. Randy Anderson, the referee, and fans, don't forget now, as I mentioned, tomorrow, 7 o'clock Eastern Time at Starrcade 91. Exclusively on pay-per-view from the Norfolk Scope Arena. And as great a combination as Steamboat and Rhodes are, the chances that they will be partners tomorrow night are 1 in 40, because there'll be 40 names put into a hat. They'll be drawn at random to create 20 tag teams that will compete in 10 tag team matches. They could very easily be on opposing teams tomorrow night at Starrcade. It's Sullivan starting out with Dustin Rhodes here. That's starting out very quickly. Good shoulder block by the Natural. Dailing Peterson, drop kick. And the youngster from Austin, Texas, starting out with a lot of offensive firepower in the early going of this contest. Tremendous lariat to pair of them. And if you wonder why Barry Windham is here at ringside, if you were with us the last couple of weeks, you know exactly the problems that Ricky the Dragon Steamboat has had individually with the Dangerous Alliance. 2 weeks ago, it was Beautiful Bobby. Last week, it was Stunning Steve. We know Barry Windham's motivation once he is cleared to wrestle, which we hope will be in just a few more weeks, will be to get even with the Dangerous Alliance, especially Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko. Good chain wrestling move by the Natural. Tags in Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. World Tag Team Champions have really been in a war in recent weeks with Arn Anderson and Beautiful Bobby, specifically of the Dangerous Alliance. They certainly want to be the World Tag Team Champion. Good move there by Steamboat. Peterson tried to drop down, avoid Steamboat, but that did not work. Remember, fans, that you have the opportunity to be a part of Starrcade 91, just as we will be. We look forward to being in Norfolk at the Scope. All the great fans from around the country that will be traveling to Norfolk. But if you aren't able to do that, we encourage you to call your local cable company and enjoy Starrcade 91 in the comfort of your own home with your family. Great move there by the Dragon. Look at this. Puts them both down. One with a headlock, one with a head scissor. Tag made, and here comes the really a tremendous young athlete, Dustin Rhodes. Arm drag takeover. We'll be talking to the Dangerous Alliance in mass in this program. And as we mentioned, it's certainly, we want you to stay tuned for many reasons, but one in particular, what happened to Sting recently was beyond description. I cannot describe what Sting endured at the hands of the Dangerous Alliance. Oh, what a lariat. And as I mentioned, specifically ravishing Rick Rude. We saw last week the one altercation that Rude and Sting had. Irish move by the Dragon. Out off the top rope. And they won it convincingly.
The winners of the match, the team of Ricky Steamboat and Dustin Rhodes.
Remember, fans, still to come in this broadcast, PN News and Mr. Hughes in a battle of super heavyweights. Johnny DeVad is here, plus the U.S. Tag Champions, the Young Pistols, and much more. As we take a look, what teamwork. A phenomenal tag team combination. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, Dustin Rhodes. And we'll talk to their adversary from the Dangerous Alliance when we come back on TBS. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to TBS, back on World Championship Wrestling from the center stage in Atlanta. A little bit later in the broadcast, as I mentioned, we'll show you that piece of videotape involving what happened to Sting at the hands of the Dangerous Alliance. I'm sure that's one of the issues that you would like to address at this time.
When I returned to World Championship Wrestling on October 27th, I vowed I would become the head of the board of directors, and the way to do this was to eliminate your top hero, Sting. Sting has been eliminated from World Championship Wrestling. First, we took his title. Then we took his spirit, because all the little Stingers look up now and they say, you know, Sting, you're not half the man ravishing Rick Rude truly is. And now later on in this program, you will see that Sting is no longer physically capable of wrestling here in World Championship Wrestling. You might as well go up north and sign a contract elsewhere where the physical demands are not like they are here in World Championship Wrestling. Sting! I was your judge, and the Dangerous Alliance was your jury, and they found you guilty, and your executioner was ravishing Rick Rude. Ladies and gentlemen, the men that eliminated Sting from World Championship Wrestling, ravishing Rick Rude and the Dangerous Alliance.
And the Dangerous Alliance making their way to the ringside momentarily. And there they are, ladies and gentlemen, en masse, the entire Dangerous Alliance.
Now, I would like to stand out here today and tell you that World Championship Wrestling has dropped to its knees, looked up at me, and said, yes, we will give the Dangerous Alliance a seat on the board of directors. But you see, Jim Herd and everybody on the board of directors, they're not that smart. So we're going to have to not only eliminate Sting, but now the son of a drunken plumber from Austin, Texas, Dustin Rhodes, you're next. Ron Simmons, with a rap sheet this long from the neighborhood, who represents the people. What people? The people in jail? You're next. Barry Windham, with a broken paw, who couldn't hold up his end of a former organization. You're next. And now, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, with the wife at home, carrying the little baby, ravishing Rick Rude, has a personal message for you.
Ricky Steamboat, the short distance you came from striking the First Lady of Wrestling was literally within an inch of your life. Ricky Steamboat, you have been warned.
Now let me make this perfectly clear. so that there's no mistake about it. Sting, Rhodes, Wyndham, Simmons. This war against World Championship Wrestling is not over until I have a seat on the board of directors and that there's a man in a white collar standing over the grave of World Championship Wrestling, and he says, Dominus Ominus, in nomine Patri, in Filii, in Spiritu Sanctum, Amen.
Very strong comments, ladies and gentlemen, from the Dangerous Alliance, carrying Mr. Roode out on his shoulders. We have not heard the last of Sting. That piece of footage still to come in this hour, and we're going to have Cactus Jack momentarily, but first, this week's Top 10.
And now here's a look at the WCW Top 10 rankings in singles competition as compiled by members of the WCW Board of Directors and promoters for the weekend of Saturday, December 28th. Holding steady at the number 10 spot for the second week in a row, from the Rocky Mountains, Big Van Vader. In at number 9, the Cruncher of the Dangerous Alliance, Larry Zbysko. The number 8 man, the Natural Dustin Rhodes. In at number 7, up one notch from last week, Cactus Jack. Ricky Steamboat continues to move. This week he's at number 6. The number 5 ranked man for the second week in a row, Scott Steiner. In at number 4 once again this week, Stunning Steve Austin, the World Television Champion. The number 3 ranked man, the dog-faced gremlin Rick Steiner. Sting moves up to number 2. And the number 1 ranked contender, the current U.S. Heavyweight Champion from Minnesota, Ravishing Rick Rude. And of course, the WCW World Heavyweight Champion, the Total Package Lex Luger. And that's the Top 10.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring area at 284 pounds from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, here comes Cactus Jack. And his opponent already in the ring from Clearwater, Florida, 221 pounds, Ian Weston.
Well, fans, Cactus Jack, as you all know, involved in a tremendously physical feud with Heavy Metal Van Hammer. One of our featured matchups tomorrow on the main event will feature that man, Cactus Jack and Hammer, one-on-one. And of course, this Wednesday night, January the 1st, 7:30 in the Omni, it's Fan Appreciation Night. And that means that all upper-level seats will be priced at only $3 if purchased Wednesday at the Omni box office only. It will be Cactus Jack and Ravishing Rick Rude taking on Sting and Ron Simmons. One of the many, many great main events this Wednesday night, January the 1st, 7:30 starting time in the Omni for Fan Appreciation Night. We'll be telling you more about that in this program. Cactus Jack and Heavy Metal Van Hammer, as many of you fans are keenly aware, have really hammered on each other, no pun intended, as far as Heavy Metal is concerned. And tomorrow they will go one-on-one on the main event with Tony Schiavone and Missy Hyatt at 6:05 Eastern Time, right here on TBS. The 284-pounder from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, has certainly established himself as one of the most dangerous competitors in the history of WCW. And Ian Weston going up top, taking a chance that did not pay off. WCW Magazine with Eric Bischoff still to come. And speaking of that publication, it will, the first issue of 92 will be out in a couple of weeks. And I understand that Cactus Jack is one of the leading vote getters thus far in the most hated wrestler category. We can understand why. High impact move by Cactus. Very unpredictable and certainly very unorthodox. And one has to really think just why, with all the weapons that the Dangerous Alliance possesses, there's a double arm DDT. Would Paul E. Dangerously retain his services for one night only in the Omni Wednesday?
The winner of the match, Cactus Jack.
I think the answer to that question is very obvious. dangerously wants that man to assist ravishing Rick Rude in ending Sting's career once and for all. There's the double arm, DDT, Cactus Jack. Ravishing Rick Rude take on Sting and Ron Simmons this Wednesday in the Omni. And we'll be back with WCW Magazine and Eric Bischoff after you hear this.
Welcome back to TBS. I'm Eric Bischoff, and this is a WCW magazine. It's Starrcade 91 weekend, and the eyes of the wrestling world will be tuned to Norfolk, Virginia, and the Norfolk Scope Arena for this Sunday's pay-per-view spectacular. I encourage you to call your local cable company and order this event for the enjoyment of your entire family. 40 of WCW's finest athletes will compete to see who will qualify for Battle Bowl, a two-ring battle royal. Now, in order to make it to Battle Bowl, a wrestler must first survive the tag team portion of the competition. As you know, the 20 tag teams will be drawn at random via the Lethal Lottery. Now, this promises to put some very unique teams together. But in order to qualify for Battle Bowl, however, a team, no matter how much they may dislike each other, must win their tag team bout. Only the 10 winning teams will advance, and once in Battle Bowl, it will be every man for himself. In other WCW news, Jushin Thunder Liger has become the new WCW light heavyweight champion. That, the result of a very close victory over Flyin' Brian Christmas night in Atlanta's Omni. We hope to have footage of that bout next weekend here on TBS. Our congratulations to the new champion who will compete this weekend at Starrcade. And the Dangerous Alliance, led by the psycho yuppie Paul E. Dangerously, have once again attempted to put an end to Sting's career. It happened at a recent event when Jim Ross was interviewing the rookie sensation Marcus Alexander Bagwell and Dangerously decided to intervene. Here's a look at a portion of that incident.
I want to beat him up! I want to beat him up! Arm! Put the handcuffs on him! Put the handcuffs on that miserable, stinking, no good son of a...
Can you believe it?
Sting will enter Starrcade this weekend, somewhat battered and bruised, but he will be there to extract revenge on the Dangerous Alliance, specifically the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude. But wouldn't it be interesting to see if Sting and Rude, via the Lethal Lottery, were tag team partners at Starrcade? And what if Ricky the Dragon Steamboat is forced to tag with, say, Beautiful Bobby or Stunning Steve Austin? Well, after what we've seen the past 2 weeks here on TBS, that could be a disaster for the participants. Here's a quick look at what happened when Ricky the Dragon Steamboat first wrestled Eaton and then Stunning Steve Austin here on TBS over the past 2 weeks.
To strike a woman. Wait a minute, from behind. Ricky, look out from behind. It's Stunning Steve Austin. Steamboat now has to fight off both these men from the Dangerous Alliance. Eaton and Austin doing a number on Steamboat. Austin retains the title via disqualification. What if there's Beautiful Bobby? Eaton and Austin, again, double teaming on the Dragon. They don't want to make him, let him make it to the Christmas Night Army event. Eaton and Austin trying to destroy the Dragon.
With all the recent events that have occurred in WCW over the past few weeks, it would certainly seem to me that this Sunday's pay-per-view exclusive is potentially the most exciting event ever presented by World Championship Wrestling. Call your local cable company now and order Starrcade 91 Battle Bowl. And as I leave you for this edition of WCW Magazine, here's a look at the 40 men scheduled to compete at Starrcade 91.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way into the ring area, accompanied by Alexander York at 239 pounds, from Vero Beach, Florida, Terrence Taylor. And his opponent already in the ring at 208 pounds from Venice, Florida, Rick Ryder.
Terrence Taylor, a very complex individual, without a doubt. a lot of rumor, innuendo regarding his stay, his extended stay in the York Foundation. We have documented on the wrestling hotline. I've talked about it on my radio program on AM 750 WSB. As a matter of fact, Taylor was on the program with Tony Schiavone this past Sunday about Taylor's, does he want to stay in the York Foundation or not? I'm going to try to get a word with Taylor and York in this broadcast, if possible, and address that situation. Taylor starts off with a full Nelson on Rick Ryder. Randy Anderson, the referee for this contest. Taylor, one of 40 men that will be involved in Starrcade tomorrow night, exclusively on pay-per-view. We certainly want you to call your cable company and be a part of that first ever Starrcade 91 Battle Bowl. Without a doubt, the most unique concept in the history of pay-per-view television. As I mentioned earlier, if you cannot be with us live in the Norfolk Scope Arena, we hope you'll call your cable company and enjoy this tremendous event with your family. Taylor dropping a vicious knee on Ryder's head. Taylor, a very arrogant, somewhat conceited athlete, quite frankly, but a highly skilled one. A veteran of over 10 years in this very competitive sport. Snap Mares Ryder over. I would think it would certainly be a blow to the York Foundation for them to lose their charter member if that does take place. Remember, if you just joined us, Sting has been perhaps, of course, in the mind of the Dangerous Alliance, decimated by that organization. We'll show you exactly what transpired later in this broadcast. The Stinger, obviously the most marked man in WCW as far as Dangerously and his organization is concerned. Right hand by Taylor. Taylor, the master of the five arm. Miss York looking on with her trusty computer at arm's length. Taylor has certainly showed a different philosophy since joining the York Foundation. One of total disdain for the fans, and that's certainly unfortunate. Ryder now firing back, showing his competitive spirit. Good drop kick there. Hesitation by Ryder. Got up very quickly with a drop kick, but Taylor now taking back over. There's a gut wrench into the power bomb.
Not today. Not today. Not today.
Taylor says five arm, and Ms. York is saying neck breaker. Ms. York wanted the neck breaker. Let's see if she gets it. No, Taylor does it his way with the five arm, and it was very effective.
The winner of the match, Terrence Taylor.
Well, Taylor did it his way, and it got a victory. I guess that's what matters. Taylor, one of the many athletes at the Omni this Wednesday night, 7:30 during Fan Appreciation Night. All upper-level seats, only $3 if you purchase them Wednesday at the Omni box office. And now I'll make my way to ringside to talk to Terrence Taylor and Alexander York. And we're here, ladies and gentlemen, with Alexander York and Terrence Taylor of the York Foundation. And apparently there is some sort of dispute as far as Mr. Taylor and this organization is concerned.
There's no dispute, a little miscommunication. The York Foundation told Mr. Taylor to use the neck breaker. He chose to use the five arm. I don't know.
I was in there with my opponent, and I thought it was time to use the five arm. I thought that's what time it was. It was time to get out.
Not pay you to think, Mr. Taylor. We pay you to do what we tell you to do, to follow our guidelines, and that's it. No thinking involved.
Well, if that's the way you think, if that's the way you feel, why don't the York Foundation, why don't you go your way, and I'll just go mine. Let's just start right now.
wait a minute. We began this whole thing with you, Mr. Taylor. You're the charter member. You began it all. We've got time and money invested in you. As you know, there's a meeting tonight. If you will be so kind as to show up at that meeting and participate, maybe we can get things worked out.
I'll be there.
Well, I guess they'll have a meeting tonight, and I hope they will update you on that situation next week here, ladies and gentlemen. And we'll be back with more on WCW from Center Stage right after this. Time out.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way into the ring area from Motown at 403 pounds, here comes P.N. New!
The big man from Motown. He'll take on the Diamond Stud tomorrow night on the main event right here on TBS. They were involved in a big tag team matchup last week. Tomorrow it's one-on-one.
I've heard it said that I should raffle my life, and if I had to do it, I wouldn't think twice. So you can diss me, I don't care what they say, cause that's not the game that PN News would play. So if you're listening, take my advice or ask my opponent, it ain't worth the price. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo! Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo!
Oh, Mr. Hughes trying to gain the early advantage, and PN News hammers the big man. Hughes and News right here, a battle of super heavyweights, and they're getting it on, ladies and gentlemen. Roll! He rammed him face first into the steel. Mr. Hughes just rammed News right face first into the barricade, and now hammering right above the right eye. Hughes, what a sadistic attack here. He doesn't care about wrestling. And here comes some help from the locker room. Hughes and Van Vader, who will soon meet the Steiner brothers. And it's obvious that Hughes is in a fighting mood. PN News has been decimated by Mr. Hughes. His eye has been injured here. And the side of his face is rammed into the steel.
God, my eye, man.
There you can see the results
of
what has just transpired. News went right to the steel, face first. That eye's already swelling shut. Oh, what an ordeal we've just seen here. What a tragedy here at Center Stage. PN News face rammed into the steel right in front of me. And we hope to have a report on his situation before we go off the air. Without a doubt, as I mentioned, Mr. Hughes and Big Van Vader have their sights set on the Steiner brothers. Hughes certainly is able and capable, along with Van Vader, in challenging the Steiner brothers. But what a tragedy for PN News. We hope that his cheekbone has not been broken. His eye was swelling shut as he left to the locker room. We'll have more on that, but right now let's go up to Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way into the ring area. At 236 pounds, he hails from Huntsville, Alabama, it's Beautiful Bobby. And his opponent already in the ring from Baltimore, Maryland at 222 pounds, Joey Mag.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we understand that PN News is being attended to by medical personnel. We'll try to have an update on that situation before we go off the air here tonight. if at all possible. I mentioned that during that melee that Mr. Hughes and Big Van Vader, who weighs 445, soon to take on the Steiner brothers in a tag team war. And obviously Hughes is physically ready for that tremendous tag team matchup. Beautiful Bobby of the Dangerous Alliance locking up with Joey Maggs. Beautiful Bobby will be one of five members of the Dangerous Alliance involved tomorrow, 7 o'clock Eastern Time at Starrcade 91. And I think it would certainly be poetic justice if Sting were partners with one of the Dangerous Alliance. It certainly is possible. Again, that exclusive videotape documenting what has to be considered one of the worst nights of Sting's entire wrestling career. We will bring that to you exclusively here on TBS later in the broadcast. Wrist lock takeover by beautiful Bobby. Eaton controlling the action here with jumping Joey Maggs. As we have mentioned, Eaton and Anderson, two of the greatest tag team wrestlers that I have ever seen in my entire career. Certainly making a bona fide threat to wrestle the World Tag Team Championship away from the title holders, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Dustin Rhodes. Our fans that were with us in the Omni at Christmas night certainly know exactly what I'm speaking of. And they're tremendous 2 out of 3 fall matchup. There is the leader of the Dangerous Alliance, Paulie Dangerously, who certainly seems obsessed in getting a seat on the board and controlling its actions. Wrist lock applied by Eaton, who's controlling the action here offensively. Still to come, Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko in one-on-one competition. Johnny B. Badd will be here, and of course Johnny B. Badd will be wrestling the new WCW Light Heavyweight Champion, Jushin Thunder Liger, this Wednesday on Fan Appreciation Night in the Omni. As you heard in WCW Magazine, Liger won the title Christmas night in the Omni against Flying Brian, and we hope to have footage of that matchup here next week on WCW. Kids really having a good time here at Center Stage. And remember, in the Omni, Wednesday night, all upper-level seats are only $3 if purchased Wednesday at the Omni box office. Great opportunity to bring out the whole family for Fan Appreciation Night in the Omni Wednesday. Starts at 7:30, by the way. Good arm drag takeover by Joey Maggs, but a counter move into the head scissor, back into the arm bar by beautiful Bobby. One thing about the Dangerous Alliance, I wholeheartedly disagree with their philosophy, but they certainly are the deepest and most talented group, or gang, if you will, to ever compete in WCW. And that includes the Horsemen, in my estimation. This is the premier organization in the history of WCW. Think about it. With Ravishing Rick Rude, the U.S. champion, Stunning Steve Austin, the television champion, Anderson and Zbyszko certainly could be the world tag champions. It would give Dangerously a tremendous leverage advantage when negotiating with the promoters of World Championship Wrestling. Anderson and Eaton certainly are no strangers to the championship, the tag team championship, that is. They have both been champions on many occasions, and Dangerously knew that full well. when he signed these men to what we understand are very lucrative contracts for his organization. Mags trying to figure a way out of this hammerlock. Finally rises to a vertical base. Backs Eaton into the corner. That's going to break the hold with the help of his elbow. Right hand. Not a lot of power in the right hand thanks to the hammerlock, but the kid's fighting back. And beautiful Bobby goes right back to the arm. Like him or hate him, that is great strategy. Selecting one body part, going for it. We want to remind the fans that we'll have some predictions on Starrcade 91.
He's just like Sting, Rick. He's just like Sting. He's garbage.
Well, he's on the phone. That shouldn't surprise anybody. But we'll have some predictions and some thoughts on Starrcade on the wrestling hotline. Some injury updates, some last minute late breaking news on the wrestling hotline until midnight tonight. And of course, Gordon Solie and Lance Russell will broadcast Starrcade live on the wrestling hotline. That'll begin at 7 Eastern time. Good move there by Joey Maggs. And beautiful Bobby in. Double arm suplex. It's already been a very unique hour, to say the least. And what about this Terrence Taylor, Alexander York? This alleged meeting. And I'm wondering if that's just for the two of them. Apparently so. We'll hope to update you on that next Saturday here on WCW. Beautiful Bobby now with a neck breaker and the scoop slam up on top. If he hits this one, I'll assure you it'll be over. Alabama jam, and it hit its mark. Beautiful Bobby has won it here decisively.
The winner of the match, Beautiful Bobby.
Beautiful Bobby and the Dangerous Alliance in their entirety at Starrcade on pay-per-view tomorrow, 7 o'clock Eastern time, and they'll be deeply involved in the big one in the Omni. January 1st, that's this Wednesday at 7:30. And fans, when we come back, the assault from the Dangerous Alliance continues on TBS. Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko is next.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring area at 240 pounds from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko. He is accompanied to the ring by Medusa. And his opponent already in the ring from Seymour, Indiana, 205 pounds, Scott Sandlin.
America's leading country music personality, Rhubarb Jones, completes his ring introduction. Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko with Medusa at ringside to take on Scott Sandlin. And ladies and gentlemen, I've been joined by the leader of the Dangerous Alliance, Paul E. Dangerously.
The man so dangerous they wouldn't let me do this job on a permanent basis. So here I am now once again talking to you, and I guess you feel at home with me standing next to you again, don't you?
Not particularly, but that's not the issue.
What is the issue?
The issue is what your gang did to Sting. It's too bad that you couldn't do it one-on-one,
Paul. Oh, yeah, isn't it?
All five guys had a jump on. That's a real sign of a lot of bravery and courage, isn't it?
We never said that we're brave. We never said that we have a lot of courage. What I said when I came back on October 27th was that Sting would be eliminated from World Championship Wrestling. You might as well let him go anywhere else in the world now, because he's not physically capable to wrestle
here anymore. That's your opinion, and you're not a doctor.
I don't need to be a doctor. I'm an expert. That's why I've been a commentator. That's why I'm a manager now. I'm an expert. You're a commentator. You commentate on the facts. And the fact is that Sting has been eliminated. No more Sting in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, we're going to show that piece of videotape later in this broadcast, and the fans can be the judge for themselves. And look at Medusa now. She's getting involved. She's got no business getting physically involved in these matches.
Yes, she does. I hire her to do that. That's Ms. 007. She's the director of covert operations. How many times are you going to tell you, wham?
Zbyszko just has been relentless working on the arm of young Scott Sandlin here.
He's the cruncher. This man enjoys the sound of a human bone crunching. Did you hear it on the audio tape when they slammed the door on Barry Windham's hand and the sickening sound of the bone crunching?
Well, that's something I wouldn't brag about.
Larry likes that.
Well, Larry is going to get his comeuppance when Barry Windham gets back in action.
Barry Windham is a lot like all these other great athletes that have suffered career-ending injuries.
Now, why is he continuing to hammer this kid? He's obviously got him outclassed. He's got him up. He's physically a better athlete than Sandlin. Now, he doesn't give a darn about pinning this kid right now. He wants to break his arm or his hand, just like what happened to Barry Windham.
You see, some people in this world are ignorant enough to drink. Some people are ignorant enough to use substances. Larry Zbyszko gets his euphoria by hearing the bones of another human being crunch. He crunched Sammartino, he crunched Bockwinkel, and he crunched Barry Windham's hand. Much like Ravishing Rick Rude crunched the career and the hopes of all the little stingers.
Well, we'll see how much crunching he does Wednesday night in the Omni, because on Fan Appreciation Night, he's going to take on El Gigante. Now, crunch that.
Crunch what? What are you putting in my hand?
This kid has got to give it up. Referee's got to stop it. This kid is hurt. And now look at what's Zbyszko doing here.
He's going to crunch his back. Wow! Oh,
dropped him right on his head. Compressing the vertebrae. Dropped the kid right on his head.
Now, you say I'm not a doctor, but I can tell you one thing. This kid needs a doctor right now.
Well, we need medical attention here very badly. This kid has got a neck injury, and that's the most severe kind. Fans, we've got to take a break. This kid needs some help, and we'll be back.
I love it.
Well, welcome back, everyone, here to WCW. They're helping the young man out of there. Thanks to Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko. Wait a minute, Zbyszko! This guy's hurt! And Zbyszko, Sandlin, can't even defend himself. What is the meaning of this sort of brutality from the Dangerous Alliance? And something must be done about Dangerous Lee and this organization. Perhaps they'll be dismantled at Starrcade, I don't know, but this kid is hurt very badly. And it's a very dangerous neck injury.
The fans will try to have an injury report on Scott Sandlin as well as PN News before we go off the air, as I mentioned. And now I'd like to talk to a man that's just coming off the injury list. The former Florida State All-American, Big Ron Simmons, not only will be at Starrcade tomorrow night exclusively on pay-per-view, but Ron will be back in Atlanta's Omni on Wednesday on Fan Appreciation Night. Ron, it's great to see you back here, my good man. I know that you've got a very busy weekend. You're going to come back to competition tomorrow night at Starrcade during the Battle Bowl this Wednesday. You're going to be at the Omni. It's going to be a big week for you, my friend.
Yeah, I can't think of a better way to come back than to be back here and see all the good fans again and to be back and starting back on the biggest show of the year, and that's Starrcade and that's Battle Bowl. And one thing I like to tell you and the people that, if they don't understand, well, being up there at Starrcade and being in the Battle Bowl, anybody can wind up being your partner. Your names will be pulled at random out of a bowl or a hat, and my partner, I would love better than none of it to be Barry Windham. or Dustin Rhodes or Ricky Steamboat, but it could wind up being a Lex Luger. Let's not be with that, though, right? Let's go for this. Whoever it's going to be, one thing Ron Simmons has in his mind, and that is getting into that battle bowl and beating everybody that he comes encounter with.
Ron, also, I know that you're excited about being back in the Omni Wednesday night, fan appreciation night, 7:30 starting time. That's going to be a special one for you as well.
Well, Jim, if I may, let me say something now. Paulie Dangerously walked out here and said this, and believe me, there's nothing in this world bigger in his mouth but my right hand. Now, let me tell you this, Paulie Dangerously. You said Sting was eliminated. Yes, but it wasn't because you took him out in a fair fight. Look what you had to do. The man came back on a limp leg and still almost took you out, Rick Rude. Now, you come out here and try that in Ron Simmons' match. You do that this Wednesday night in the Omni. Yes, I'm from the hood like most of these people out here are, like most of these people in Atlanta are. You do that to Ron Simmons Wednesday night in the Omni, and I'll promise you one thing, brother. Somebody won't leave that ring walking.
All right, number 50 is ready. The Starrcade tomorrow night, Wednesday night in the Omni. Right now, let's go back up to Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring area at 239 pounds, he hails from Macon, Georgia, it's Johnny B. Badd!
And his opponent already in the ring from Durham, North Carolina, 268 pounds, here's Chuck Coates.
Well, fans, it's certainly great to hear from Ron Simmons, and I know that he's excited about Starrcade as we are.
And Johnny loves you, baby.
Johnny B. Badd, along with Ron Simmons on Fan Appreciation Night this Wednesday, 7:30 in the Omni. Johnny B. Badd to take on Jushin Thunder Liger. Remember, it's Fan Appreciation Night in the Omni Wednesday. All upper-level seats priced at only $3 if you purchase them Wednesday at the Omni box office. And as we mentioned earlier,
look at me, baby. I'm beautiful.
Liger is the new WCW light heavyweight champion. Johnny B. Badd really had this crowd on their feet. Has certainly become, since dismissing his manager, Theodore Arlong, he has become one of the most popular athletes in WCW, without a doubt. Former 5 times Golden Glove champion. Still has that dynamic left hook. Great one-loss record, but he's going to be in the ring, and the fans in Atlanta know, with one of the most fascinating athletes in the history of this sport, in Jushin Thunder Liger. It will be a stern test for Johnny B. Badd and his left hook Wednesday night, 7:30 in the Omni. Chuck Coates, a little bit bigger man than Johnny B. Badd. Has got great quickness, great foot, hand and foot speed for that matter. Great movement in this contest. Johnny B. Badd takes him up and over. Good move, goes to the air, and a nice drop kick. And the Badd man from Macon. Arm drag takeover into the arm bar. Still to come, the U.S. Tag Team Champions, the Young Pistols. And also that shocking videotape involving the Dangerous Alliance and Sting. Johnny B. Badd meeting Coach coming in. The clothesline takes him right down. That was from the right side. And now Johnny B. Badd going up top. Sunset flip right off the top. And he got it.
The winner of the match, Johnny B. Badd.
Well, Coates up very quickly to try to gain a little measure of revenge here after Badd's victory. Johnny B. Badd with a clothesline, and they want to see the left hook. And third, oh man, Johnny B. Badd. Tremendous left hook. He's going to pin him again. Thought he was going to make it 2 in a row in just a matter of moments over Chuck Coates.
Can he do that to Jushin Thunder Liger? They don't throw left hooks like that in Japan, I can tell you. And there it is.
That's the kiss that don't miss. I'm pretty and he's ugly.
That pretty well says it all. Here's how he got the pin, the high risk move off the top. Johnny B. Badd. 1 of 40 at Starrcade, exclusively on pay-per-view. Who will his partner be? We'll find out via the Lethal Lottery on pay-per-view, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, tomorrow night. And fans, when we come back, it's the Young Pistols. They are next.
Ladies and gentlemen, making their way into the ring area from Wyoming with a combined weight of 460 pounds, the U.S. Tag Team Champions, Steve and Tracy, the Young Pistols. And their opponents already in the ring with a combined weight of 451 pounds from Birmingham, Alabama, Don Michaels, and from Columbia, South Carolina, Butch Malone.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, mentioned earlier that Big Van Vader and Mr. Humes had their sights set on the Steiner brothers. They're the Patriots. We know who their sights are set on, but the Pistols have issued a challenge to the Steiner brothers, and here's what Steve and Tracy had to say about it. So it looks like a couple teams gunning for the Steiner brothers. They are the measuring stick as far as tag teams are concerned in WCW, without a doubt. Good double team move, but Firebreaker Chip and Todd Champion taking their seats at ringside. I saw them here earlier. You know they cannot wrestle on TBS for approximately 60 days now since losing here on TBS last week. So they're not wrestling. They've got their tickets and they're right at ringside. They came to see one thing and one thing only, and that's the Young Pistols, because even though they can't wrestle them here on TBS, doesn't mean they can't wrestle them in an arena. And that match has been signed. There's the tag. Waistlock. And Steve up on top, drop kick off the top. U.S. Tag Champions are gonna win it here.
The winners of the match, the Young Pistols.
Well, the Young Pistols have won it. What are they doing here? They've already won the match. What's the point of this? Why would they continue to punish this guy who can't even defend himself? There's no reason for what they're doing. This guy is in a helpless position. And I don't think that Champion and Chip are going to stand for it. Champion came over the rail and was met by both Young Pistols. Oh, Champion ran face first into the steel. Firebreaker Chip came over the rail. He's met by both Armstrong and Smothers. The U.S. Tag Champions doing their damage on the Patriots. And they have really asserted themselves here. Well, the match is over. The Patriots are ready to fight, not wrestle, as the U.S. Tag Champions return to the locker room. All the Patriots were trying to do was to save the young man from any more punishment. Champion was coming to the ring. He was met right there by both the Young Pistols. They really did a number on him here. Watch the impact of the steel. And then it was Firebreaker Chip who got double teamed. When we come back, that dynamic and shocking piece of videotape involving Sting and the Dangerous Alliance is next.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross back at center stage, and as we have been talking about throughout this broadcast, I'd like to take you back to a shocking piece of videotape. It all started when Marcus Alexander Bagwell was in a match. I had the opportunity to talk to the rookie from Sprayberry High School from nearby Marietta, Georgia. Then Paulie dangerously got involved, and the rest, as they say, is history. Sting suffered a tremendous beating at the hands of the Dangerous Alliance, especially Ravishing Rick Rude. But as we pick this videotape up, it was Marcus Alexander Bagwell in one-on-one competition. The impressive rookie, Marcus Alexander Bagwell, to take on John Peterson here. And Bagwell certainly has been one of the bright spots in WCW when it comes to the rookies. And for 1992, one would think this kid is going to be heard from quite loudly, for that matter. Good hip lock takeover. Bagwell, an outstanding high school athlete from Sprayberry High School in the Atlanta suburb of Marietta, Georgia. Arm drag takeover. He's been spending a lot of time being taught the ins and outs of this very physically demanding sport by great athletes like Mike Graham, Dustin Rhodes, Flying Brian, and Sting. Even though Sting has had his share, to say the least, of problems with the Dangerous Alliance, Sting is taking time out of his schedule to help this young man, which I think speaks a lot for all those men that volunteering their own time to help another. Arm drag takeover. This kid's got a great future. And he'll admit to you that he's a long way away from being where he wants to be, but I really believe that if he can prevent injuries and keep progressing. Sting told me just the other day that this kid really had a great aptitude and a wonderful attitude. Stuck his head right in the sternum of John Peterson right there. Got him up in a suplex, hooks the leg, and he just controlled this one from the outset.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
Fans, we're going to talk to this good kid right here in just a few moments. But look at the suplex, perfectly done. Another victory for Marcus Alexander Bagwell, and I'm sure all the fans in Marietta, Georgia, all your alumni at Sprayberry High, very proud of you, and looks like it's really coming together for you.
Jim, I can't tell you how excited I am to be here. WCW's giving me my chance, and I'm finally showing myself. I got two wins under my belt now. I'm really excited to be here.
While I'm interviewing this young man.
I understand that. First of all, Mr. Bagwell, I'd like you to know that unlike the company that employs the both of us, the Dangerous Alliance is an equal opportunity organization. Now, as you know, the world's greatest athlete is Stunning Steve Austin. He is the world's television champion. And on behalf of Mr. Austin, I'd like to give you, sir, the opportunity of a lifetime next week right here on television. Because you are a great competitor, Stunning Steve Austin would like to give you a shot at the world's television heavyweight championship.
What an opportunity there, Marcus.
Hey, it sounds great, Mr. Davis. I really appreciate you offering it to me. I gotta say, no, I'm not physically ready. Steve Austin's a great wrestler, and I'm not ready for that ability yet.
No, you won't take a shot at Stunning. See, let me tell you something, Bagwell. Where the Dangerous Alliance comes from, we make people offers that they cannot refuse. For example, there are two kind of breaks in World Championship Wrestling. The first kind of break is the one that Stunning Steve Austin is offering to you. The break of a lifetime, a shot at the world TV title, the best wrestler on television. The second kind of break is a broken bone. For example, this is what happened to the last person that refused an offer from the Dangerous Alliance. Let me just ask you this, Bagwell. Did your mommy and your daddy tell you to stay away from success because you don't want to run with the big boys like the Dangerous Alliance?
You're getting way out of hand, Mr. Dangerously. Way out of hand. It's got nothing to do with my mom. It's got nothing to do with my dad. It's up to me. Mike Graham's been training with me. Dustin Rhodes been training with me some. Sting has been taking time out with me. Sting.
You've been training with Sting.
He is taking time out of his sporting schedule to work with me, especially.
You are listening to advice from Sting when I'm offering you the opportunity of a lifetime. You stinking, miserable, ungrateful, prepubescent punk. Let me ask you something. When you go to Sting for advice, does he tell you an opportunity knocks at your door? Don't answer it, because Stunning Steve Austin is knocking at your door. You understand what I'm saying? Opportunity is knocking at your door.
Well, wait a minute. Dangerous Alliance attacking this kid. I mean, they are tearing him apart. Marcus Alexander Bagwell is being physically decimated. This whole place is shaking. They're hammering this kid, breaking him apart.
Oh, pick him up. I want to beat him up. I want to beat him up. Arm, put the handcuffs on him. Put the handcuffs on that miserable, stinking, no good son of a...
Can you believe it? Oh, there's a Stinger! Stinger! Taking care of business! Danny DeFisco! Danny Austin! Knocking down Eden! He knocks down Anderson! Steve came to Kid's aid! And he's fighting the Dangerous Alliance single-handedly! Putting it from behind! There's Rude! Ravishing Rick Rude! Got it from behind! Oh, the Rude Awakening! Brought here on the stage!
No doubt the Dangerous Alliance wanting to end Sting's career. We don't know how badly Sting is hurt. We feel very certain that he will be at Starrcade this Sunday night and in the Omni on Wednesday night. We hope to have his comments on this broadcast next Saturday. But as we end this broadcast, let's take one more look at what happened.